Baltimore woodworking show is about to start, about 10-15 minutes. We'll have a crowd around here. And, have a look at the Pantorouter setup we've got. Have a protective screen that we put up in front of the Pantorouter just in case. And we're able to introduce our new dust collection system because we did get the patent filed on it. And it is working flawlessly. There was not more than a cup of debris after 2 days of demonstrations, constant demonstrations. The main demonstration I'm using is the double mortise and tenon. It's kind of an interesting one. This is the little stand that I built that the Pantorouter goes in, and also all of my templates, my guide bearings, my router bits. Everything's all nice in order. And it's lockable overnight. On the other end, I have this door that is able to accommodate the Pantorouter on its little tray that I built so that it goes down in there and is secured on both ends for shipping. The wheels are removable. They're on a little pallet, so I can pull that off and be able to ship it in this crate. This has been awesome. After I start here, and then between operations, I just stop the Pantorouter, and the vacuum, by the way, is connected to the Pantorouter, of course, so it starts and stops with it. So it's been an awesome demonstration. I'm able to show which templates are available, which ones come with a hybrid Pantorouter. And one of the guys yesterday challenged me to do dovetails and to see how long it would take. In 7 minutes, we were able to set up and cut these dovetails that are just absolutely perfect. They're ready for glue. So this is what we're demonstrating mostly, is the double mortise and tenon. And of course, the feature attraction here is our operable demo. And the beauty of it is that I'm able to show people how the Pantorouter works by following the template with the guide bearing, the blue guide bearing, and then how that information is translated to the workpiece via the router. And I'm able to start and stop the operation. So, kind of fun. And then we have our TV demo going with our loop video. But certainly the star of the show is our operable demo. It's really been fun to have in the booth and for people to see. And so many people have come up and said, "Oh, I watched Matthias build that. That's awesome." In fact, a couple of people yesterday said, "The reason I'm here is that I saw that you were going to be here on the show, or on the YouTube video, and that's why I came." So, pretty fun. We'll get ready, get set up, and we'll have a crowd around here very soon.
You get the larger and the smaller using the mortise and tenon templates, and because this is 2:1, this will make a tenon, a mortise and tenon, is 2.5 inches, 1.25 inches, by 8 inch, 1/4 inch, 3/8 inch, or 1/2 inch each one. So the full range of mortise and tenon capabilities, and so those will look like that. Okay, that's the small one, and 1/2 inch, and can see some of the others. Here's one cut into 45. And happens with the larger one. So in addition, you can either buy this from us, this doublet plate, or we can put four of them on there and put four mortises in there. You can put these on horizontally or vertically, whatever you desire. And just by changing the template, because that's what comes with it, the optional ones, just by changing this template, we're able to use to make a box joint or finger joint, either quarter inch or half inch, just by changing the router bit. We change the template again and put the dovetail template on, and we're able to make dovetail templates faster and more accurate than I have really ever been able to make. It's under 10 minutes from startup to glue. So we only have three that are optional like this. But again, these come with it. And then you can, let me show you how this works. We'll show you how to make a double mortise and the instruction number here to get it out of work. The first thing we do is to find our thickness. And we do that by using our
you see how that's what it'll carve out.
We'll find it at the back. We'll lock that down, lock our template down, and everything is transcribed from the template side to the cable side at half scale. So knowing full thickness here, now our router bit knows half the thickness at the router bit at the table side.
Right now, that is cutting.
We lock that down.
Puts it in the inner.
Makes it slightly off center. A bit easier for me to see on this side. So I'm going to put up the guide bearing that we want.
Yeah, Washington, they made those.
Mount that. You can see that our templates are all tapered slightly. The reason for the taper is that different router bit manufacturers have very slightly different sizes. So they're not all precisely half inch. Only my sharpened ones have a little smaller one. So by running it up and down the taper, we're able to accommodate those different sizes. So I'm going to find the end of my workpiece, and then I'm going to set a depth stop. And I want to make these about 3/4 inch. So I'll set that depth stop in the back. Just a quick safety check, make sure everything's locked down, and we're ready to cut.
Sharp end on the top.
Through the middle. Tie this one time around, same thing up. There we go. Perfect double mortise, or tenon, excuse me. And the reason this is such a high quality cut is that because we have perfect control due to our pantograph, we can use a climb cut. Anytime you can use a climb cut, you're going to have much higher precision than you would otherwise. You can pass that around and feel that. Now we'll do the corresponding mortise, and we just line that up to the front of our table here. We'll use this clamping method I've got. We're going to change our guide bearing. Use a small one. Put that in the center slot. Find the face. Set our depth to slightly deeper than the tenon was long. Safety check. Ready to route. That's two. Where is our piece?
Just have to get it started.
No worry. I have a little bit of size here for this structure wood that you could see perfect fit. We're glue ready in just a couple of minutes. Now, just by changing our template, we can now go to a box joint template. And we can use a quarter inch bit and cut quarter inch box joints just as fast as I can do those bonus and tenon. Put in a half inch bit, make half inch box joints. I can change my template again to a dovetail template. And this is the greatest challenge to me. I don't know about you guys, but cutting good dovetails is a real art. It's no longer with this machine. We can make perfect dovetails, and it took 7 minutes from the time we thought about it to the time we had a glue-ready drawing. The reason for that is that we're not trying to hold a piece of material over a template or over a jig and do this with it vertically. In fact, you know, if we wanted to have something rather long, this would be kind of unwieldy. We're not trying to hold a router and cut into it. Instead, we've got everything buttoned right down to the table, clamped down. We're using a 2-to-1 mechanical advantage with the pantograph to get perfect control with our cut. The other thing is that this is the safest way that I've ever thought to operate a router. That you can notice where my hands are relative to a spinning bit. I don't have to be close to it in order to cut very fine detail work or larger work as well. So this is the first time that we've shown it.